नकलैर्विधूयते सुधा सुधारा मधुरं पदे पदे दिने दिने चंदन चंद्र शीतले यशो यशोदा तनयस्य गीयते. So this is a very, very beautiful verse quoted by Srila Rupa Goswami. Srila Rupa Goswami says, Aho, aho vir na kaler vidhuyate. Oh, the sun, the scorching sun of Kali Yuga doesn't act on one person. Na kaler vidhuyate. Instead, sudha. What does sudha mean? Sudha. Not one drop. Sudhara. Unlimited quantity. Sudha. Sudhara. Madhuram pade pade. Instead of being scorched by the sun of Kali Yuga, there's one person who is tasting sudha, nectar, madhuram, sweetness, sudhara, unlimited quantity, pade pade at every step. Not just that. Dine dine, day by day, what happens? Chandana chandra sheetale. Instead of being scorched by the sun, he is soothed by the moon beams. He feels so happy as if his body is anointed with sandalwood pulp and he's standing under the Chandrika, Prema Bhakti Chandrika, the moon beams of nectar. Who is this person who enjoys so much? Only one person. Yasho, Yashoda Tanayasya Giyate. He who sings the Yasha, the fame of Yashoda Tanaya Krishna. So that devotee who's singing, speaking, hearing, all the devotees who are singing, speaking, reading, hearing, chanting, remembering Sri Krishna. Aho, aho bhir na kaler vidhuyate. They are not touched by Kali Yuga. Sudha, sudhara, madhuram, pade, pade. At every step they taste only nectar. And dine, dine, as they mature in their spiritual life, chandana, chandra, sheetale, they feel so much happiness. Srila Prabhupada was asked, how do we know we are making spiritual advancement? Srila Prabhupada answered by saying, when you eat roti, you don't need a certificate from outside to say that your hunger is satisfied. You feel fulfilled. Bhakti pareshanu bhavo viraktir. Three things are happening as we eat. Hunger comes down, body gets nourished, and we feel happy. So we don't need certificate from outside, said Prabhupada. Prabhupada said, it comes from within. That feeling, that satisfaction will come from within. So similarly, when we progress in spiritual life, three things will happen. The hunger of material thirst will reduce, must reduce. Srila Prabhupada in one purport, he writes that the chief symptom of advancement in spiritual life is reduction in material desires. So the hunger of material enjoyment will come down. Second, just like food brings in satisfaction, the person feels very happy and joyful in performing bhakti. Doesn't need any extra pays and perks. Prabhuji, if you do this service, you will get this. No. The service in itself will be a pay and perk. You don't use the service to get something. The service will purify. And third, just like honoring prasadam makes the body nourished and strong, one becomes very much fixed up on the path of bhakti. So this is the glorious life of a devotee. Now the question is, are we tasting this? If not, why not? We should taste. This Bhagavatam is filled with nectar. Is Bhagavatam to be read? No. Don't read Bhagavatam. Drink Bhagavatam. Pipata Bhagavata rasamadayam muhuhu. Again and again. Pipata. Pipata, drink. Acha. Drink what? Bhagavata. Rasa. This nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam. But there's a very beautiful word used. Rasamalayam. Please tell me, what is Vidyalaya? Place of learning. Granthalaya? Place of books. Bhojanalaya? Huh? Place of eating. After that, Shauchalaya? So, alaya means place. The source. Pibata Bhagavata Rasamalayam. This is the house of all rasa, taste. But interestingly, the word laya, explained by Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur in Madhurya Kadambini, the word laya means to fall down. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says there are 5 signs of weak chanting, inattentive chanting, and first is lay. How do you write lay in English? To lay down, L-A-Y. Spelling matches English and Sanskrit. Laya, L-A-Y, lay down. So laya means to fall. But alaya, a means too much. Just like nanda means happiness, a plus nanda, too much happiness, ananda. Shrama means hard work, a plus shrama, ashrama, too much hard work. Shraya, to take shelter, a plus shraya, complete shelter, ashraya. So laya, to fall down, a plus laya, fall in such a way that you never get up. Pibata Bhagavata rasa. How much should we drink? Alaya. Here to fall down. Completely. Not spiritually fall down. Faint in ecstasy. Then here to wake up again, and when you wake up, here again to go in ecstasy. So there is no question how many times to read Bhagavata. Sometimes we ask this question, Prabhuji, kitne bar padna chahiye? Ek bar, do bar, teen bar. This doesn't work. One senior Prabhupada disciple once came to Atlanta in America. And we were all sitting in Prabhuji's class. Very, very wonderful Vaishnava. So he was speaking, and at the end of the question, the class, there was Q&A, and one devotee put his hand up. He said, Prabhuji, I have read Bhagavatam 4 times. And then Prabhuji said, oh, you're keeping count? Which means the actual reading has not begun. He's saying, if you're keeping count how many times you've read, means actual reading has not begun. Actual reading begins when it goes on. This was his statement. So I got bewildered. I didn't ask any question after that. So Narad Muni is also asked, how many times should Bhagavatam be read in the Bhagavat Mahatmya? Very nice question, right? You want to see what Narad Muni says? How many times Bhagavatam should be read? Please repeat. Sada Sevya, Sada Sevya.
Sada Sevya, Sada Sevya.
Srimad Bhagavati Katha.
Srimad Bhagavati Katha.
Yasya Shravana Matrena.
Yasya Shravana Matrena.
Hari Chittam Samashrayet.
Hari Chittam Samashrayet.
Narad Muni is saying, how many times to read Srimad Bhagavatam? Sada Sevya. Srimad Bhagavatam must be served. Sevya. Worthy of service. Sevya. Bhagavat Katha. Sa. A. So Sevya. Sada Sevya. Sada Sevya. 2 times. What does Sada mean?
Always.
Kirtaniya.
Sada.
Sada Sevya. Sada Sevya. 2 times. Srimad Bhagavati Katha. This Bhagavat Katha must be served forever. Serving Bhagavatam means hearing Bhagavatam, reading Bhagavatam, sharing Bhagavatam, book distribution of Bhagavatam. Now Bhadra Purnima is coming, see? So this, we all as a community should be fired up to as many Bhagavatam sets as possible from our temple. We must touch more and more newer souls outside who need, who want Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavati Katha, Sada Sevya. What do we get by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam? Yasya Shravana Matrena. Matram. Only. Just by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, what happens? Harihi Chittam Samashrayet. That Hari, who shelter we are supposed to take, he ends up taking shelter of the heart of the listener. Krishna enters the heart. Yadgatva Nanivartanta. He enters the heart of the listener, now he doesn't know how to get out. Srimad Bhagavatam himself describes. Shrunvatam Shraddhaya Nityam Grinhatam Cha Swacheshtitam Kalena Nati Dirghena Bhagavan Vishateridi Pravishta Karana Randrena Swanam Bhava Saroruham Dhunoti Shamalam Krishna Salilasya Yathasharat. 284, 285 Bhagavat. Bhagavatam is describing, when we hear Hari Katha, what happens? Krishna enters the heart. Pravishta Karana Randrena Swanam Bhava Saroruham. He enters through the ear hole and sits on the lotus flower of the listener. The heart is like a lotus flower, so he's sitting on that lotus flower. Hey Krishna, what do you do sitting on the lotus flower? Don't worry. Dhunoti. He cleans. Aise free mein nahi baithe hain. Clean karte hain. Kya clean karte hain? Shamalam. Dirt. Bhagavatam says, dhunoti shamalam Krishna. The all-attractive Lord, who cannot even clean his own house in Vrindavan. Mother Yashoda uses help from other places, but he gets so captivated. Oh, this person is hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. He enters the heart and he takes it as his swadharma. He cleans. An example given is salilasya yathasharat. Just like if there is muddy pool of water, when it keeps raining for some time, that good water replaces the muddy water. Similarly, our heart has muddy water of material desires. When we keep hearing Srimad Bhagavatam continuously, this rain water replaces the dirt and the water becomes pristine. Please repeat. Janmantare kritam punyam tada bhagavatam labhet. Janmantare kritam punyam tada bhagavatam labhet. The Bhagavatam Mahatmya describes. Only when a jiva has performed aneka janma arjita, not papa, sukriti, aneka janma, janmantare kritam punyam, when one has performed punya for millions and millions of lifetimes, tada bhagavatam labhet, bhagavatam readily walks into the life of a jiva. Not saying that the jiva reads. Bhagavatam walks into the life, boss. Now if the jiva takes advantage and starts reading and hearing and sharing and speaking and remembering and offering prayers through the Bhagavatam. Even Sri Hari cannot describe what that jiva is going to get. Tamadidevam karunanidhanam tamalavarnam suhitavataram apara samsara samudra setum bhajamahe bhagavata swarupam. Padma Puran, Bhagavat Mahatmya. That this Bhagavatam is the only bridge across the ocean of repeated birth and death. Bhavasagara. And he is non-different from Krishna. Just like Krishna. Very wonderful point. Just like Krishna, he appears in the Chandra Vamsa. And Ramachandra appears in the Surya Vamsa. You see the Surya, the sun goes through 12 zodiac signs in 1 year. The sun, representing the Supreme Lord, goes through 12 zodiac signs in 1 year. Similarly, this Srimad Bhagavatam sun goes through the 12 cantos in one reading. Krishna Surya Sama Maya Hai Andhakar. Krishna Swadhamopagate Dharma Jnana Divisaha Kalo Nashta Drisham Eta Purana Arka Adhuna Udita. 1343 Bhagavatam. That this Srimad Bhagavatam is rising like the sun. Why are we not having taste? Why are we not reading Srimad Bhagavatam? That Srimad Bhagavatam which Prabhupada sacrifices night sleep for, we cannot even sacrifice our daytime for that Bhagavatam. Forget night time. This Bhagavatam is kept in the shelf. It is a matter of great misfortune. Great misfortune. In our parampara, Srinivas Acharya, Narottam Das Thakur, and Shyamananda Prabhu, the three Acharyas of the same generation, they were the founder Acharyas of the book distribution movement. They distributed the Goswami literature far and wide. Now, interestingly, Srinivas Acharya He went all the way from Navadvip, all the way to Neelachala just to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And when he reached there, everyone is crying because Sri Sachinandan Gaurahari had disappeared. Imagine, Prabhupada was in this temple and you get to know. And you take your car and by the time you come here, they say, Prabhupada was here, now he has gone to another temple. Hare, I came all the way. You go to that temple, they say, no, Prabhupada has gone to America now. Now what do I do? Kaha jau, kaha paun, how can I get Prabhupada's mercy? This was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Srinivas Acharya went all the way. He couldn't find Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So then when he was crying and weeping, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in his meditation and said, don't worry, Gadadhar Pandit, Radharani is still present on the planet. Take shelter of Gadadhar Pandit and learn Srimad Bhagavatam from them. Please take shelter of Gadadhar Pandit. So he went to Gadadhar Pandit. Hey, Gaur Gadadhar. Smara Gaura Gadadhara Keli Kalam. Shunu Gaura Gadadhara Charu Kathabhaja Godruma Kanana Kunja Vidum, says Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Radha and Krishna have appeared in Kali Yuga as Gaura Gadadhar. Srinivas Acharya went and took shelter of Gadadhar Pandit, who was weeping. He said, please teach me Bhagavatam. I wanted to take shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has left. Gadadhar Pandit said, yes, I can teach you Srimad Bhagavatam. The problem is I don't have Srimad Bhagavatam. You don't have Srimad Bhagavatam? What about this copy? Gadadhar Pandit said, no, actually this copy, Gauranga Mahaprabhu and myself, we would read together at Tota Gopinath. And while we would read this copy, crying and weeping, all the pages have got wet. Now, I'm not even, the ink has all smudged all over the place and I cannot even see what is coming up next. Please go and get Srimad Bhagavatam. Now Srinivas Acharya is thinking, how do I get Srimad Bhagavatam? He goes back to Navadvip. Now it's not easy to get Srimad Bhagavatam. It's not like our generation. No generation had Srimad Bhagavatam with so much ease. We can just walk into a temple and how many of us are sponsoring? 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, Bhadra Purnima special, 20, 30 devotees are sponsoring. Without a worry where those sets are going to come from. We know Hamare Godown mein hai, we can give. But he went back to Navadvip. And to get now Srimad Bhagavatam was tough. Why? Original Srimad Bhagavatam. No printing press. You can't have soft copy, Kindle, Amazon, ye wo, nothing. You know, download, right click, kuch nahi kar sakte. You have to rewrite the whole thing. And now if you make a mistake while rewriting, the words of Srimad Bhagavatam will change. So, to write on that paper, you need bark from the tree. To write with the ink, you need the proper organic material to write, which you can use as a pen and an ink to write. Then, the person who is writing must be a Brahmana who understands what's happening. And he should be able to write with proper legible handwriting that can be seen. Because one matra goes here and there, then finished. Like even in Hindi, for example. Roko mat, jane do. What does it mean? Roko, mat jane do. You see, same sentence, if the comma is put in a different place, different meaning. Roko mat, comma, jane do. Don't stop, let him go. Roko, comma, mat jane do. Opposite meaning, just by comma. So person who's writing must be vigilant. 18,000 verses, he shouldn't make a mistake. Srinivas Acharya took 8 months to get it done. Went back to Neelachal Dham, everyone is crying. Gadadhar Pandit just left his body. He's gone back home, back to Godhead. He didn't know what to do. Gadadhar Pandit appeared in his meditation. He said, don't worry. Rupa and Sanatan are still on the planet. You take shelter of them. Srinivas Acharya took Srimad Bhagavatam and ran to take shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left. I went to take shelter of Gadadhar Pandit, Gadadhar Pandit left. When I take shelter of Rupa and Sanatan, they have left. Now what to do? Who's there to give me shelter? Chaitanya, Srila Rupa Goswami and Sanatan Goswami appeared in the meditation of Srinivas Acharya and said, don't worry. Jiva Goswami and Gopal Bhatta Goswami are still on the planet. You take your Bhagavatam and surrender your life at the lotus feet of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Take Diksha from Gopal Bhatta Goswami, but learn Srimad Bhagavatam from Jiva Goswami. Now he said, but what if they disappear? He said, don't worry, I will tell them to be on the planet, says Rupa Goswami. So more merciful than Gauranga, more merciful than Gadadhar, more merciful than Rupa and Sanatan were Jiva and Gopal Bhatta Goswami for Srinivas Acharya. Srinivas Acharya went running. He doesn't know where Jiva Goswami is there, where Gopal Bhatta Goswami is living, because there's no like WhatsApp group, no website, shoot an email, no GPS, nothing, absolutely. You don't know in Vrindavan where Rupa and Sanatan, their Anugatya Jiva and Gopal Bhatta are staying. So he knew Radha Govindadev temple is something that is visited often. So he said, if I sit in Radha Govindadev temple and keep crying, hey Jiva Goswami, hey Gopal Bhatta Goswami, someone will take pity. He went to Radha Govindadev temple and started crying. And Vaishnavas noticed and they held him by the hand and took him to Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Gopal Bhatta Goswami was at that time crying and weeping and serving Radha Ramanji near Nidhivan. And he embraced Srinivas Acharya and handed him over to Jiva Goswami. And then Jiva Goswami taught Srinivas Acharya, who was the disciple of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. And there also was Narottam Das Thakur, who was the disciple of Lokanath Goswami. And also Shyamananda Prabhu, who was the disciple of Hridayi Chaitanya. So in this way, all three of them met under the auspices, under the shelter and the umbrella of Jiva Goswami's teaching. And then they took all of this and went out for book distribution. The first ever campaign. This is how difficult it was to make one copy of Srimad Bhagavatam in the past. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur was searching for Chaitanya Charitamrita in Bengali, in Bengal, it took him years to get it. Very precisely, it took him 8 years to get one copy of Chaitanya Charitamrita in Bengal. Some biographies of Bhaktivinoda Thakur also say, different scholars also have different opinion as far as the time frame. Some say it was 8 months, some say it was 10 months, some say it was 3 years, some say it was 8 years. But the point is, it took him a lot of time. So it was inaccessible. The point I'm making is, those shastras which were inaccessible in the past, and also even if they were accessible, they were inaccessible as far as language is concerned. They were all in Sanskrit. One is accessibility of structure. Another is accessibility of substance. You see? You see a difference between form and substance? Srimad Bhagavatam is the form, the book. Then opening up the Bhagavatam and understanding is the substance. So the book in itself, the structure in itself, the form in itself was inaccessible. What to speak of now decoding the substance? Never in the past was Shastra, especially Srimad Bhagavatam, so easily accessible. But guess what? Ati parichayat avajna. Malaye bhilla purandri chandana tarukashtam indanam chakurute. The tribal lady on top of the mountain, she's surrounded by sandalwood trees all over the place. So when she feels cold, what she does is, she cuts a couple of sandalwood trees down and makes bonfire. Just to heat her body, she's cutting down sandalwood. Can you imagine what Veerappan goes through when he hears this? The sandalwood chauragra ganya purusham. He lived all his life with one pointed attention on sandalwood. Chandana charchita neela kalevara peeta vasana vanamali. Aha. But however, a tribal lady who doesn't understand the value of sandalwood, she's surrounded by sandalwood all over the place. Take two trees I can cut down, take the wood and make some bonfire. Just for heat. Why? Ati parichayad avajna. Familiarity breeds contempt. We have all over the place a Veda base hai, a soft copy, a hard copy. Every temple has a set. Take care, no problem. Even if I don't read, it's not a big thing. We don't see reading of Srila Prabhupada's books as a necessity. We think, if I read, good. It is a favor I am doing. But even if I don't read, look, I am doing good. I am doing my rounds, everything is okay, bas. But then that is why, even over years, we are stagnant. We don't make advancement. So the point is, how do we take advantage of Srila Prabhupada's books? What are the steps that we can put in our life to take advantage of Srila Prabhupada's books? One. Yes? Daily reading. Yes. Daily reading. Now, how to read is also a science. It is a science. The same book is accessible for everyone. But the way we decipher it is different. Is it not? First and foremost, when we open up Srila Prabhupada's books, the question oftentimes asked is, Prabhuji, I don't have taste in reading, what do I do? This question has been asked so many times in public. So many devotees, you know, we hear time and again, so many speakers come and speak about Prabhupada's books, and we, sitting in the audience, we ask the same question. The point is, Haridas Thakur mentions in Harinam Chintamani, when the same question is asked with respect to taste in chanting. How do we develop taste in chanting? Haridas Thakur in Harinam Chintamani explains, the taste of chanting doesn't come first. The effort towards chanting comes first. Like Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Anartha Nivritti, Nishtha, Ruchi, Bas. What comes first? Nishtha or Ruchi? Nishtha. Does Ruchi come first? No. So first comes Shastra Nishtha, then comes Shastra Ruchi. First comes Japa Nishtha, then comes Japa Ruchi. First Seva Nishtha, then Seva Ruchi. First comes Nishtha. First making an endeavor. Harinam Chintamani, Haridas Thakur is explaining, if taste is not there, it is not going to come from any other process. Taste for Harinam will come by performing Harinam. By chanting Harinam with Nishtha. Taste ho, na ho, doesn't matter. Keep chanting. Duty bound. Chant attentively. Then when Krishna sees that this devotee is not having taste, till he is endeavoring so much, Krishna gives little taste. Now when that taste comes, the devotee starts chanting and now wants to chant more. And because he is not able to meet his target, he feels dainya bhav. Oh, I am not able to do it. That induces another grace of mercy. So, it goes on in a cyclic process. After that, when taste comes, the more the taste, the person feels, I don't have taste. But the initial step is one must put in hard work. Mother Yashoda, she didn't think, Hare Krishna, you come. Come here. Stand here. Wooden grinding motor leke aao. Keep it behind you. Achha, wahan rassi rakha hai. Jao leke aao. Then Krishna brings rassi. Put it around. Aise ulta karo. Put it around. Now tie. Good. Doesn't work like that. This is not Damodar Leela. Swinnam Vaktram. Mother Yashoda is sweating. Running. She's tying her sari. She's tying her hair. It's all getting loose. She's perspiring. Gasping because Krishna is jumping. He's popping and jumping. Very, very restless. Chappala Shiromani. Very restless. So he's jumping all over the place. Mother Yashoda is running. Nishtha first. Ruchi later. First I will run. First I will sweat. I will bind him. It is impossible to bind him. He's unbound. Sthane sthita shruti gatan tanuvak manobi yaprayaso jita ajita. 10.14.3 Bhagavatam Brahma Stuti. Brahma is saying, Jnane prayasam udapasya namanta eva jivanti san mukarita bhavadiya vartham sthane sthitaha shruti gatan tanuvak manobi yaprayaso jita ajita. That ajita, he cannot be conquered. He becomes conquered by prayasa, jnane prayasam, by hard work, sthane sthitaha, being wherever we are. Sometimes we think, Prabhu, I'm not getting time to chant and read. It's because of my job. If I change my job, I will have time. In that time, I can read and I can chant. This is a grihastha scenario. It doesn't work like that. Why? On a Sunday we have time. Do we chant? Our problem is not lack of time. Our problem is lack of taste. That is our problem. So Krishna will not give new job. Ghiso usi mein ghiso. Because if you get time, you are watching TV. If you are getting time, you are going here, there and talking all these things. Usse acha you burn your karma in an IT field. Chalo. Work hard. Karmani nirdahati kintu chav. Karo. But being there, when we make that extra endeavor, I don't have time, doesn't matter. If death comes tomorrow, I cannot say, aap ek hafte baad aao na, mere paas time nahi hai. You have to be where you are and put in hard work. Now, do somehow. How you do it, that is your creativity. You have to spend time somehow. Take some time out. Start, trick Maya with small, small pieces, as she does. Ek bar piyo, kuch nahi hota hai. अरे मैं नहीं पीता दारू कुछ नहीं मेरे लिए आवर फ्रेंडशिप एंड देन दैट पर्सन स्टार्ट्स विद वन आई हैव हर्ड दिस इज हाउ इट हैपेंस आई डोंट नो आई हैव वेरी ऑनेस्टली आई हैव हर्ड दिस एग्जांपल मेनी टाइम्स आई हैव नो एक्सपीरियंस सो इफ देयर इज समवन हु हैज हैड अ पास्ट हिस्ट्री प्लीज डोंट थिंक दिस फूल ही डजंट नो यू नो वेल आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग आई डोंट नो आई हैव हर्ड दिस एग्जांपल सो Prabhupada said, keep it as it is, so I'm repeating. But I've heard, he starts with small, small, what, glass? Peg? Peg. Peg? Peg? Peg. P-E-G. G or K? G. Okay, peg. So he starts with small, small, Theek hai. Now, just because we are in the temple of Daru Brahman doesn't mean you keep speaking about Daru like this. Daru Brahman means wooden deity. But so much Daru charcha should not be done. Anyway, the point is, with little pieces, he becomes a drunkard. So the same thing happens in spiritual life. We take little time out every day. And little by little hard work. Now, when we break that somehow that cycle that I'm not able to do. Nahi, hoga, karo. Hoga, don't give excuses. If you want to do, you will find reasons. If you don't want to do, you will find excuses. Karo. 5 minutes, 10 minutes. You have to eat, right? As Mataji is reheating the prasadam, you just 5 minutes, read something. Share with her. Share with your kids something. Start with something. Boond boond se ghat barta hai, as they say. Little drops. You know. 5 years down the line, when you see, you made so much advancement. So first, we make that. And then you'll see mysteriously, as we have started to make time in our busy schedule, Krishna now starts moving our life in such a way. Because now we have won His trust. When Krishna gives us time, we are investing in His service. So now, He will give change of job, maybe a place where you can reach quickly. Not in Bangalore, somewhere else maybe. Here it's like unbelievable. You go from anywhere to anywhere 2 hours. Bangalore devotees means I think 32 rounds minimum. 2 hours one way to work, another 2 hours. Back home, back to God, at Krishna will say, oh, you're... Where are you? Bangalore. Where are you from? Bangalore. You are also from... Hare, what is the secret? Prabhuji, Krishna, we chant so much, right? Traffic is there. We can hear four classes of Prabhupada one way. Oh. So we have to make endeavor. First step. Tell yourself, I want to do it. Instead of doing, I have to do it, I should do it, I want to do it. Srila Prabhupada has given me a pathway back home, back to Godhead. In gratitude, I want to read His books. Prabhupada said, the books are the basis. Prabhupada said, I eternally live in my books. So we have to read those books. Take some time out. I know one devotee who has this niyam, that till the time he has not read Srila Prabhupada's books for that day and finished his 16 rounds, he doesn't drink water. He drinks first glass of water only after finishing 16 rounds and one page of Prabhupada's books. Every day. See, you have to drink water, we have to eat. So, it's good to have that niyam. So, this is the first step. Second step, when we take Srila Prabhupada's books also, don't get overwhelmed by the size of the book. Don't get overwhelmed. Because oftentimes we think, if I read 10 pages a day, how long will it take to finish Srimad Bhagavatam? Don't worry about it. Never get into a PhD program thinking, 3 saal mein mujhe bahar aana hai. 4 years I have to finish somehow. Such a person with that mentality will never finish a PhD. Even when we do Govardhan Parikraman, nowadays people are, you know, asking, kitne ghante mein hua? How fast did you finish? Somebody, 6 hours. Still Kanishtha. 5 hours. Madhyam. 4.5. Ati Uttam. Govardhan Parikrama is not PT Usha competition that you have to run. Govardhan Parikrama means relish the process. Serve Sri Giriraj through the body. If we start our parikrama thinking, itne ghante mein I have to finish, then the mood is in finishing. It's not in the process of performing parikrama. When we walk through the parikrama, we are supposed to see, this is Chandra Sarovar. Oh, this is Kusum Sarovar. We offer our obeisances, chant a round of japa, we pray to the Leela Sthali. In that we absorb the consciousness that is present there. Not that we just keep running around. That is good. But it's better if we go deeper. So when we take Srila Prabhupada's books, take sections out. Instead of thinking, I want to finish in 1 year, in 2 years or 3 years, take a section. Next 3 months, I am going to focus on the section of Dhruva Maharaj, for example. Aage piche main kuch nahi janta. Next 3 months, only Dhruva Maharaj, first time. In 4th canto Srimad Bhagavatam. And at home also, keep pictures of Dhruva Maharaj. That inspires, this is what I want to do. Next 3 months, by the time this festival comes, let's say now this is September. So let's say Kartik Mas, or you know, end of Kartik Mas, that'll be I think about 13th of November or something, 15th, something like that. So 2 months from now, September to October, October to November, 2 months. In these 2 months, let's say Damodar Leela, you know, because it suits the context more than Dhruva. So I want to read. And every day make an attempt, keep a notebook. Again, this is one out of the many ways Srimad Bhagavatam can be studied. Keep a notebook. Don't run. Stay there. Pause. Take a verse. Try to see every word in that verse. Try to connect it to your local mother tongue, colloquial language. Kannada, Telugu, Tamil, Malayalam, Marathi, Bengali, whatever it may be. There are many words which match because they all originate in Sanskrit. So, making that attempt. This verse is very nice, very crispy. This verse, for example, describes, switching topics, describes, let's say, the qualities of Dhruva, which Shukdev Goswami is bringing out to name, introduce Dhruva Maharaj. Qualities of Sudama Vipra. Krishnasya Sitsakha Kashchit Brahmano Brahmavittama Virakta Indriyartheshu Prashantatma Jitendriya. 5 qualities of a Brahmana are given. Oh, Brahmin initiation means these 5 qualities. That realization. Oh, Brahmana means this is expected. So just one verse actually. But then taking the essence out. Brahmano, Brahmavittama. Oh, one must be learned in Shastra. Virakta Indriyartheshu. One should be detached from sense gratification. Prashanta Atma. One should be peaceful in all circumstances. You know, like His Holiness Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj. When I see Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj, almost all the time I think, this is unbelievable. It's unbelievable. Do you also think like that? So transcendental to material nature. Like the current of Sattva Rajas Tamas is going in some direction and Maharaj is in Vishuddha Sattva. So how devotees, how Brahmanas should be. How Sudama Vipra was. So you just write those points in the book. Virakta Indriyartheshu. Prashanta Atma, Jitendriya. Then, to help, you have word to word from Prabhupada also. This is another interesting point. No commentator gave word to word for 18,000 verses of the Bhagavatam. Prabhupada just didn't give us overview. See, before every chapter, Prabhupada gives an overview of the chapter, summary. Why? Just in case if someone is a rush, cannot read the whole chapter, at least the summary if they read, they will know what is happening. How much Prabhupada is thinking? Shukdev Goswami never gave summary like that. No commentators, even in Hindi, you see other places also, they don't give like that. They just give verse translation, verse translation, verse translation. Prabhupada gave synopsis in the beginning, the summary in the beginning, then the verse, and that too Prabhupada gave the verse in Sanskrit and then the verse in English. What if we don't know to read Devanagari script, we will say, Prabhupada, I feel I'm not able to read. Prabhupada said, no problem. I will write it in English. This is not seen anywhere, by the way. Outside ISKCON, it is not found. This concept of reading Sanskrit through English. You say diacritics outside ISKCON, people don't know what it is. Some words which Prabhupada has blessed us with, my God, it helped me in my GRE. When I was preparing for this GRE and TOEFL exam, you know, to go to America, in the verbal section of GRE and the TOEFL, the test of English as foreign language, you know, I could use words which they were thinking, wow, what is this? Hey, it's Prabhupada's books. Diacritics, time immemorial, cosmic manifestation, transcendental, phantasmagoria. Even Shakespeare doesn't know what phantasmagoria is. You seen? Unbelievable. These are jewels which just flow as byproduct to Prabhupada's books, by the way. It's not like the main selling point. The main selling point is Krishna Bhakti. Is of side mein, collect fruits to the side. Aha. Giving the Sanskrit through English, one. And that too, it's not just the English. I say, for example, if you have to say Yashoda, it doesn't just say Y-A-S-O-D-A. Nahin, S ke upar dot line, Krishna, R ke niche dot. It's not Krishna, na, so the N also has a dot. It is not Yashoda, it is Yashoda, so A has a line. Aha. Who has done all this? Prabhupada's mastermind, Prabhupada's genius. So that we don't give any excuse, I'm not able to read. Okay, next excuse could be, I'm able to read the verse, but I don't know how to properly read it. So at the end of the book, Prabhupada gives pronunciation guide. If it is this, it is either, then it is ah. How the mouth should open. Some places Prabhupada writes also, like A here is like the A in this word in English. You see? The O here is like the O in rock. O, rock. Prabhupada gives like that also. And then the next excuse could be, okay, I know to read properly, but I don't know what the words mean, word to word. Every word you can sit peacefully and read. Acha, this means this, this means this, this means this. Then you can write down. These are the words I can learn. And because Sanskrit is a very interesting language, the words are used in other places also. So if we know to catch, then in other places when they are used, we can guess. Ah, Prabhupada gave this meaning. So another very beautiful byproduct of Prabhupada's books is no need to learn Sanskrit professionally. If you want to learn, that is another thing. As Prabhupada encouraged Pradyumna Prabhu and others to learn professionally. But it is not that bina Sanskrit mein Bhagavat nahi pad sakta. No. Prabhupada has broken that excuse of ours. Every verse, every word has a meaning and he is giving very clearly. After that, general translation. Then what can I learn out of it? Bhakti Vedanta purport. No commentator gives so much. For this is for every verse of Gita, of Bhagavatam, of Chaitanya Charitamrita. And that too in the Bhagavatam, when Prabhupada comes up to Brahma Stuti, Canto 10, Chapter 13, Chapter 14, Prabhupada is leaving this world on the departure bed. And you can see many close personal associates, they are keeping the recorder close to Prabhupada's lips, and Prabhupada is almost leaving his body saying, sense gratification is degrading. A Mahabhagavat Vaishnav leaving his body in Kartik in Vrindavan, he doesn't even know what sense gratification is. Whom is he speaking for? So in the purport, now when we are writing, we should take the essence. In this purport, what are the points I can learn? How can I apply this? Sometimes people say, Prabhuji, I feel the purports are repetitive. How can I understand? They are not repetitive. They are not repetitive. How do we personalize these purports? Take a pencil. Before every purport, write dear and our name. Dear so and so, please accept my blessings. This letter is in response to the letter that I received dated 6th September 1968. Write something like that before the purport. Then the purport. And at the end, your ever well wisher, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami. That becomes a personalized handwritten letter from His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami to me. Not a general one, to me. Every devotee thinks like that. Imagine if Prabhupada had written a letter in your name, personally to you. How would you take that letter? You would, you know, keep it very safe. Ghar pe lagate hain kahin. Koi bhi bhakt aaye to. And then we'll say, Prabhupada is so merciful. So merciful. Merciful on both sides. Do letter likha hai na? Merciful. We want to show everyone how Prabhupada has written for us. And we keep it very safely. Guess what? Prabhupada has written 18,000 personal letters to each one of us. And when we don't see that connect, dharme nahi na pashubhi samana. This is dharma, to see Prabhupada's hand in every purport. And to actually think about it, how in my life I can use this purport. How I can use. When I asked my spiritual master, after initiation, I asked Srila Guru Maharaj, what would your personal instruction to me be? Because every disciple wants, you know, general instruction, chant Hare Krishna and be happy. Theek hai Maharaj, but little more, you know. We want to tap that. So Srila Guru Maharaj told me, he gave me a few things as instructions, but one striking which I have written down. Srila Guru Maharaj told me, study scrutinizingly Srila Prabhupada's purports. He said the translation and the verses are common in ISKCON and outside ISKCON also. Translation, they know the story outside also. But what is special for us is the Bhaktivedanta purports. And Srila Guru Maharaj told me, these purports are very special for us because they are Prabhupada's unique gift to each one of us. As His Holiness Tamal Krishna Maharaj remembers, Prabhupada was sitting and remembering what to write at one point for 10 minutes. And Tamal Krishna Maharaj said, Prabhupada, continue writing, what happened? Prabhupada said, no. Every single word I have to think because what I write in my books will remain helping jivas in Kali Yuga for 10,000 years. And sometimes Prabhupada would have his own purports read out during morning walks and they would think and Prabhupada would say, these are not written by me. Krishna has written, I am the pen and Krishna is the author. You never give credit to the pen. The book is authored by the author. So these purports are coming out of Prabhupada's heart. Acha. When are they coming out of Prabhupada's heart? Srila Prabhupada lived in Radha Damodar temple for close to 9 years performing Hari Bhajan. He gave up his family life and lived in Radha Damodar temple as a sannyasi. And we know so wonderfully from, you know, 1955, 1956 up to 1965, 64, 65, Prabhupada lived in Radha Damodar. In that one room that we have all visited when we go to Radha Damodar. And it is described that Prabhupada's austerity was so deep there. One Babaji who lived there in Radha Damodar area, his name was Hridayananda Das Babaji Maharaj. He lived for about 78 years in Radha Kund. He was born in Radha Kund. He left his body in Radha Kund at the age of 87. And he was serving in that temple for about 78 years. Some years he spent going here and there, but then 78 years he lived in that area. And Hridayananda Das Babaji Maharaj says, in my 80 years of living in Vrindavan, I didn't see anybody cry for Krishna like A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami did. He said, it wasn't a surprise to me that ISKCON was started by Prabhupada. Because I said, he writes, he said, I knew this sadhu was up to something. He gives a very unique revelation. He says Prabhupada chanted close to 100 rounds living there every day. And he would chant continuously. He said whenever I saw A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, he would chant. And whatever little prasad he could cook and was available, he would be happy. And the effect of living in the dham, crying in separation, how he is going to do this mission. And remembering his Gurudev's instruction, add Radha Damodar, the house of Rupa Goswami's bhajan and samadhi. And after chanting 100 rounds every day, what came out of his heart is the Bhaktivedanta purports. So taking these words very seriously, make a 2-3 month plan. Bhagna nahi hai, we don't want to rush. Systematically, write everything that you can catch. And always think how I can use it. Because oftentimes we know everything. But the problem comes when life tests us. Agasur, bakasur, dhenuka, sab malum hai. Putan, dhenuka, sur. I know everything. This fundamental misunderstanding has ruined our spiritual life. One devotee was telling me when he went to New Vrindavan in America, he was giving class. And New Vrindavan has many Prabhupada disciples. You know, that's the place where Srila Radhanath Maharaj also lived. Many Prabhupada disciples even now. So when he was giving class, he's a disciple of His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj. So he was telling me this personally. He was giving class and one Prabhupada disciple after the class came to him and said, Prabhu, I'm really sorry, I couldn't attend your class. I was busy washing pots in the kitchen. I was little busy. I'm sorry, I couldn't attend your class. So this Prabhuji was telling, I am the disciple of Prabhupada's disciple. And this is Prabhupada's disciple. And he's telling me, I couldn't sit in your class. So that devotee was telling me that he told Prabhuji, Prabhuji, you know this, you don't have to sit in this class. At that time, that Prabhupada disciple said, if I had actually known it, I would be sitting listening it again. Meaning, the after effect of actually knowing something is increased desire to hear it again. When we think, putana, I know, that is a proof I don't know. Because if I had known, I would be desirous to hear it again. This taste, never thinking that I know, this illusion has spoiled our spiritual life and is spoiling our spiritual life. So reading attentively and sharing with at least 3 devotees. This is a fundamental thing. We may know it, but it comes to life when we use it, when we share it. As they say, if you want to know something, read about it. But if you want to understand something, teach it. Share it. Prabhupada said preaching is the essence. Preaching doesn't just only mean I'm going out and giving public classes. Preaching also means to speak about Krishna to someone. Bodhayanta parasparam. As Srila Prabhupada would give the example of baby Saraswati. Prabhupada would say, baby Saraswati, she goes up to people and say, do you know Krishna? They would say, no. Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. Young Saraswati. And Prabhupada would say, look, she's a preacher. It doesn't have to be a big platform. We just need like-minded, close-knit friends with whom we can share our daily reading. Every day. Prabhuji, yeh sab main aaj padha, aap bataiye. Bodhayanta parasparam. Tushyanti cha, ramanti cha. Very, very important. Then when life tests us, some remnants will come out. Otherwise, we may be a PhD in our head, but a kindergarten in our heart. We may know it, but when life comes, our responses are still the same as we would give pre-Krishna conscious days. Again, the same uncontrolled speech, uncontrolled anger. You mind your business. I know what to do. You don't teach me. Arey, then kya hua bhakti karke? Where is the change of heart? To quickly wear a dhoti, quickly wear a sari doesn't take much time. To become a devotee externally, 15 minutes. Dhoti, kurta, mathe, tilak, kanthi mala, finished. But change of heart, it takes time. So, vachanam shilam akhyati, our words and our responses to life teach us how deep our bhakti is. Prabhupada's books are not just informative, they are transformative. Anyone who studies them closely will have a change of heart. Sharing with others. Praying to Srila Prabhupada that we get taste. I know one devotee in Dallas community. That Prabhuji, he's a disciple of His Holiness Bhakti Vikas Swami Maharaj. He had a burning desire in his heart. Okay, let me tell his name also. Even if Prabhuji is saying it's glorification. Sridhar Shyam Prabhu in Dallas. Disciple of His Holiness Bhakti Vikas Maharaj. He had a burning desire in his heart that he wanted to preach. He didn't know how. He didn't know how he's going to do it. You know what Prabhu would do? He would go in front of Prabhupada and cry. Prabhupada, you have done so much for me. I am not able to reciprocate. I am aging day by day, year after year. I want to contribute in your movement in some ways. And guess what? Now Sridhar Shyam Prabhu runs the best preaching program for jail preaching in Dallas community. So many prisoners who were imprisoned by bad habits have come out, have started chanting, are even initiated as devotees. And Sridhar Shyam Prabhu is like sold out to Srila Prabhupada. I was asking him, he said, Prabhuji, Prabhupada ji aaj bhi hain. Murti nahi hai, Prabhupada ji baithe hain. He told me. He didn't tell me the story of how he cried. Some other, I was nudging other devotees. Please tell me more about Prabhuji. They said, Are Prabhuji ke baare mein kya bolu? So much nectar flows from one community to another. My God, when you travel, you see these devotees who are like hiding. But they are jewels in Prabhupada's movement. Jewels. So prioritization, Prabhus and Matajis. Prabhupada's books, Srimad Bhagavatam, is our life, is our pran. Nivritta tarshair upagiya mana bhavaushada shrotra manobhiramat ka uttama shloka gunanuvada tuman virajyeta vinapashugnat. 10.1.4 Bhagavatam. By hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, what happens? Material desires are destroyed. One gets attachment to Krishna just by reading Srimad Bhagavatam. Tachrunvan supatan vicharana paro bhaktya vimuchyen naraha. Canto 12, chapter 13, Bhagavatam. Just by reading Srimad Bhagavatam. How to read? Tat shrunvan. Before reading comes hearing. Sometimes people ask this question also. Prabhuji, what is more important? Reading Prabhupada's books or hearing from senior devotees? The answer is both. And the example given is, let's say, you invite me to your kitchen. I hope you don't. Because I'm a bad cook. You invite me to your kitchen and you say, Prabhuji, ye sab ingredients hai. Please cook a feast. You know what is cooking in Hindi? That I can do. In Hindi, pakana means to bore somebody. To pour somebody to death. Are bahut pakata hai. That Hindi perverted reflection of cooking I can do. But the English pakana, the English cooking of feast, I cannot. So if some Mataji or some Prabhuji invites me to their kitchen and says, these are the 10 ingredients, Prabhuji, you kindly cook a feast. What will I cook? Why? Mixed vegetable, simple khichdi. What I know is what I will cook, irrespective of the ingredients. But the same kitchen with the same ingredients, if an expert cook, some Mataji or Prabhuji, they enter. Now I taste their mercy, not my mercy, not my ability. I am tasting their ability. So the verses, the Srimad Bhagavatam is like a kitchen. The verses of Srimad Bhagavatam are like ingredients. When we try to just read on our own, it is like cooking the same khichdi that we can. But when we hear it from the lips of great souls, with the same verses which are like ingredients, we are hearing the best of their ability. They are showering their mercy for the same words that we are reading. So therefore, a final touch-up to our practice would be, take profuse help from hearing classes from senior devotees. If devotees are speaking, it is always good to write. Always good to write. In olden times, they would put all the Harikatha that they would hear as Shrutidar in their mastak. We cannot put it in our mastak, we need a pustak. We need a book. Therefore, we must write. And we must keep it close. And then we should incorporate what we are hearing from senior devotees in our notes of our study of Srimad Bhagavatam. And share it to others. Arey, Prabhuji, aaj Radhesham Prabhu ka class tha. I'll tell you what Prabhuji said. Bas, Narad Muni banna yahi parampara hai. Our parampara is to follow the footsteps of Devarishi Narada. What is Devarishi Narada doing? What is Vishnu doing? He is going and telling Lord Shiva. What Lord Shiva is doing is going and telling Brahma. Don't do the perverted reflection. इनके घर की सास क्या कर रही है, वहां की बहू क्या कर रही है, द मदर इन लॉ, डॉटर इन लॉ, दैट इज परवर्टेड रिफ्लेक्शन. बट वी वॉन्ट टू फॉलो नारद मुनि एज भजे हे वीणा राधिका रमण नामे, गोइंग एंड सेइंग आई हर्ड दिस महाराज क्लास, ये अद्भुत लगा प्रभु, ये पॉइंट मैं सुना ही नहीं कभी. एंड देन ही विल, अच्छा प्रभु जी आपने किनका क्लास सुना, ओ आई हर्ड दैट प्रभु जी, प्रभु जी बताओ ना कुछ. सो मच नेक्टर इज देयर इन दिस वर्ल्ड. Krishna makes it dukkhalayam, no doubt there is so much suffering. But with bhakti in the center, vishwam purna sukhayate vidhi mahendra adisha kitayate yad karunya kataksha vaibhavavatam tam gaurame vastuma. Prabodhananda Saraswati Chaitanya Chandramrita, verse 5. There is so much nectar in this world, so much to discuss. When we don't read, when we don't hear, we don't have enough substance to discuss, that's when we do paradosha kirtan. We do the kirtan of the faults of others. He shouldn't have done like this, Prabhuji. How, no? See, I understand, but you know, last time when he came to me, I behaved properly. Now, why he is ignoring like this? Oh, Mataji ka bhi aisa hi hai. She is also doing like this. Dono ka, I think Prabhuji kuch hai. I don't know. I mean, why they are acting like this towards me? This, all this material nonsense is filling our head because of lack of sunlight. Please remember the GIGO principle. G-I-G-O. Please repeat.
G-I-G-O.
Garbage in.
Garbage out.
Garbage out.
Good in.
Good out.
Good out.
So when we feed ourselves through the ears and through the eyes, through reading and hearing and chanting through the tongue, the goodness that goes in is the goodness that comes out. Squeeze a mango, what comes out? Orange juice, correct? Mango juice. Squeeze an orange, what comes out? Orange juice, correct? Orange juice, na? Everybody is doubting. Nahi, Prabhuji, mango juice. You squeeze a mango, you get mango juice. You squeeze an orange, you get orange juice. Why? When you squeeze something, what is in is what comes out. Life squeezes all of us and tests our devotion. How we respond through those testing times is what we are made up of within. All the negativity comes out because that is what is inside. So hearing Hari Katha from senior devotees, reading Srimad Bhagavatam regularly, chanting, very, very important. Tat Shrunvan, hearing, Supathan, studying very nicely, Vicharana Paro, and then thinking how I will use it in my life. By doing this, Bhaktya vimuchen naraha. Bhakti rises in the heart and the person gets liberated. Please come to the pages of the Bhagavatam. What does the Bhagavatam say? Yasyam vai shruyamanayam krishne paramapuruse bhaktir utpadhyate pumsam shoka moha bhayapaha. 177 Bhagavatam. By reading Srimad Bhagavatam, bhakti rises and all the anarthas are destroyed. वयम ही धन्यतमालोके गुरुपि क्षत्र बांधव वयम पिबा मुहुत्वत्त पुण्यम कृष्ण कथामृतम. कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 12 टेक्स्ट 43 भागवतम. परीक्षित महाराज इज ऑन हिज डिपार्चर बेड एंड ही सेज आई एम मोस्ट फॉर्चुनेट बिकॉज आई एम हियरिंग हरि कथा फ्रॉम शुकदेव गोस्वामी. सो हियरिंग हरि कथा, इमेजिन टुडे संडे, ट्यूजडे वी आर गोइंग टू डाई. कितने लोग यहां बैठ के सुनेंगे? टुडे संडे, डे आफ्टर टुमारो ट्यूजडे तक्षक इज गोइंग टू कम टू गिव मर्सी. हियर वी आर हियरिंग भागवतम, ठीक है प्रभु जी, पर तक्षक का क्या? व्हाट एम आई गोइंग टू डू फॉर तक्षक? दैट इज गोइंग ऑन इन आवर माइंड. बट परीक्षित महाराज इज सेइंग आई एम मोस्ट फॉर्चुनेट. मीटिंग अ डिवोटी इज फॉर्चून. Hearing Hari Katha from that devotee is more fortune. Hearing Hari Katha from that devotee without time bound, close to our departure, 7 days before our departure, is most fortune. Vayam hi dhanyatama. Dhanya, dhanyatara, dhanyatama. Superlative. Vayam hi dhanyatama loke guropi kshatra bandhava. Vayam piba muhu twatta punyam krishna katha amritam. Hearing Hari Katha is great fortune. ब्रह्मण कृष्ण कथा पुण्य माध्वी लोकमलापः कौन त्रिप्येत श्रुण्वान श्रुतज्ञ नित्य नूतन. कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 52 टेक्स्ट 20 भागवत. who is that person who will say, no, no, I don't want Bhagavatam? No one. Because the person who hears Srimad Bhagavatam, ye dil mange, he wants more. Sarva Vedanta Saram hi Shri Bhagavatam ishyate tad rasa amrita triptasya na anyatra syatratihi kvachit. 12, 13, 15, 12, 13, 18, Bhagavatam. This Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all that has to be known. Anyone who studies the Srimad Bhagavatam doesn't take another birth in this world again. Aha. Bhagavat Mahatmya. Nimnaganam yatha Ganga, Devanam achyuto yatha, Vaishnavanam yatha Shambhu Purana, Nam idam tatha. This is Bhagavatam. So therefore, pibata, we must drink every day. And that is true glorification of Srila Prabhupada. To sing Jaya Prabhupada is wonderful. That is our duty. But if we just do that and we don't take Prabhupada's instructions and his books seriously, Prabhupada will come out of the deity and say, bus, you now do what I'm telling you to do. You're saying, Jai Prabhupada, okay, I'm giving you my mercy. Now you read my books. Wo taste nahi hai. Then that is not very pleasing. We must do Jai Prabhupada, not just through Kirtan, but we must translate that through our study of Shastra and sharing that with devotees. This is keeping Prabhupada in the center. This is finding Prabhupada as the founder Acharya. This is respecting that personality who at the age of 70 crossed the ocean with couple of heart attacks, traveled around the globe 14 times in 11 years, establishing 108 temples. Na bhuto na bhavishyati. Na cha bhuto na bhavishyati. And Prabhupada said, those who read my books, study my books, spread my, distribute my books and preach about my books, they are very dear to me. If you want to please me, distribute my books. But we don't want to just distribute the books without we knowing what the books are talking about. Prabhupada once made a sarcastic comment, my disciples are so absorbed in book distribution that they themselves don't have time to read it. So we don't want to do that. We want to distribute Prabhupada's books in compassion. We read and we find so much nectar. And now the desire must come in the heart, what I am tasting, may this jiva also taste. And in that mode, please take this book. Bahut amrit hai isme. If the person asks, kya hai isme? Not just the parrot, like, oh, this Bhagavad Gita has been approved by, you know, Mahatma Gandhi, Henry, this, say, hey, oh, karke, chalo, see, their karma is also given, reincarnation also, 100 rupees. This is parrot-like. But when we do book distribution, acha, what is there in this book? What you have read will come out. Oh, actually, I want to tell you, you know, in this chapter, I was reading chapter 13, and this opened up, opened my consciousness to a new dimension. And the person will be interested and impressed by your commitment to the reading. Then, even if he is not impressed by the book, he will be impressed by your sincerity and say, yes, I will take. This is book distribution. This is very important for the sustenance of our movement. Please repeat. Ya idam paramam guhyam.
Ya idam paramam guhyam.
Madbhakteshu abhidhasyati.
Madbhakteshu abhidhasyati.
Bhakti mai param kritva.
Bhakti mai param kritva.
Mame vaishyasi asamshayam.
Mame vaishyasi asamshayam.
The Gita, Krishna is saying, Ya idam paramam guhyam madbhakteshu abhidhasyati. He who studies these books and speaks about them and spreads Krishna consciousness, bhaktim, he will get devotion and he will come to me of this, there is no doubt. So when the opportunity is there, when it is raining on our head in the form of mercy, why hold the umbrella of laziness and go away from Prabhupada's grace? Now is the time to throw the umbrella and bathe, taking advantage of these books. So it's already 1 o'clock. I want to pause here. If I said something which was offensive or which didn't make sense, or if I rambled upon something which was wrong, please kindly forgive me. It was not something that I planned. But if there is something which happens to be a take home out of this discussion, please don't forget to offer a kind blessing and prayer for me so that what we are sharing I can personally internalize and go deeper in my own practice. Srila Prabhupada's unparalleled Bhakti Vedanta purports in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita and Chaitanya Charitamrita ki? Srila Prabhupada ki? Gaur Premanande. Okay, if there are any questions or comments, you know, I know, because sometimes devotees, they also write me email saying that this is not fair, you speak up to the end and there's no Q&A. So if there are any suggestions or corrections or any additions or I hate to say questions, but anything that you want to share and reflections from your heart, please kindly. I saw Mataji's hand raised first, so please go ahead, Mataji. Is there a mic that can be passed? So. Very nice question. Yeah. It depends from the reader to reader. There could be different approaches, sure. The spiritual world is very colorful and very variegated. So it's not my way or highway, you know. There are many options and many possibilities. There are some devotees who are very studious. They give many, many hours for reading, very academic. So even from the beginning, they study in depth. But for others, what you could do is in the first reading, you could just go through to see what is there in which section of Srimad Bhagavatam. That is also fine. Because it shouldn't happen that we leave our body not knowing what the eighth canto is about. So one way to do is, what you could do is you can flip through quickly. That is also fine. In the first reading, you can do that. So that you know, in a general sense, what is placed where. Where Bali Maharaj's pastime is, where Dhruva Maharaj. And in that reading, if there are verses which catch your attention, you can write the numbers. Huh? I want to come back to this verse. And then next time when you're doing, you can take a section and go deeper. So at least you have read Srimad Bhagavatam once. Now you're going deeper. So that's also an approach. Yes, Mike?
When we are reading it in depth the second time, this has to be shloka by shloka, or again the shloka, like you said, we are supposed to take down the number of the shlokas that we really like, and we think of reading those shlokas in depth in future. So then every shloka we read in depth, or then only few shlokas?
It depends. Yadrishi bhavana yasya siddhir bhavati tadrishi. It depends on your inclination and taste. It's like saying, I want to play cricket. On a straight, you know, a ball which is coming straight at the middle stump, should I think of taking a back foot and pushing it down, or should I hit it down the ground? Well, it depends on how you want to do it. Take the easiest way to score runs. So another approach could be, a suggestion could be, even in the second reading, you could go on to those verses which are prayerful. Brahmastuti, Dhruvastuti, Kuntistuti, Bhishmastuti. So first reading could be general. Second reading could be only stutis, you know. Or verses which describe Krishna. Like there are verses which describe Krishna's form. Barha pidam natavaravapuhu karnayo karnikaram bhibratvasah kanaka kapisham vaijayantim chamalam randran venu radhara sudaya purayan gopavrindaihi brindaranyam swapadaramanam pravishad gita kirtihi. 10.21.5 Bhagavatam. So that now medyate bravapushe. Different things which describe Krishna's form. You can go section by section also. In the sense, topic by topic also. Krishna's bodily beauty. Prayers. Another section could be preaching verses. Verses which I can keep with me, which I could use for my preaching. You know, really quick, if I have to tell someone about something, so many people ask me about this. Ready. Like it's like Agni Astra, Brahmastra, you know. So there could be different ways, Mataji. That is also an approach. The batsman can use the stroke that he is comfortable with. Someone can, you know, hit a ball which is coming on. I'm sorry, I'm speaking too much about cricket to make it more relatable. But someone who can, a ball coming on the off stump, he could flick it to the left or to the leg stump. And someone coming, ball coming on the leg stump, he could flick it to the offside. But some offside ball, they hit it to the off, leg side ball, they, you know, it depends on the batsman. So depending on the bhav of the reader, you can take different approaches. If you want to go deep in the second, you could do that. Or you could take section by section. Depends. Bhagavatam is a fruit. There is no hard and fast rule. Isko aise hi khana hai. Usko cut karke bhi kha sakte hain. Aap usko juice bana ke bhi pee sakte hain. Aap usko chaba kar bhi kha sakte hain. Aap uske andar ke seed nikal kar bahar ka skin nikal kar bhi kha sakte hain. Phir ye fruit aap kisi ko gift bhi kar sakte hain. Bhadra Purnima aaya to kisi ko aap apple bhi fruit des, you know. It depends. These are fruits. It's no longer a realm of do's and don'ts. It's a realm of drinking the juice. Go ahead. As your heart goes, till the time we are prioritizing Bhagavatam. Now, how you do it, that's an individual approach.
Ravaji, if someone is reading like a shloka by shloka in depth, if the desire is for someone, it is there to read shloka by shloka in depth. So then is it like missing out on the important prayers, like you said, describing the form of Krishna or glory of Krishna or the prayers like that? Is it like missing out on that first and then reading shloka by shloka again in depth, if there is a desire to read it in such a manner?
Sure, go ahead.
There's no problem.
No problem. Absolutely. Prabhupada said every aspect of my books is like a fruit. You can eat it from anywhere, it's sweet. No problem. Absolutely no problem. There are many who are very interested in Srimad Bhagavatam, the lineage, the historical lineages who come. They make a family tree in their house. Raghu Vansh mein ye aaye the, unke do bacche, unka viva inke saath hua, they got married and then their kids were this. Some people, some historical mindset, they love it. No problem. It is better than doing what Tipu Sultan did, what Aurangzeb did. You know, that is again perverted reflection. But this is the actual vastava vastu. So it depends. Somebody is inclined like that. So that's fine. No problem. Any other question?
So it's an Italian word.
Yeah.
Which says that, you know, one knows how to taste things and then he can also make things out of it. So I can definitely say, you know how to taste Bhagavatam. And you also, you know, gave us a chappan bhog, you know, prepared nice and gave all of us. Thank you so much.
Actually, my spiritual master, Om Vishnupad Srila Radha Govinda Das Goswami Maharaj, has been one of the many wonderful examples in ISKCON that we have, who have been flag bearers for Srimad Bhagavatam. So, actually, when you see shopkeepers in different places, if someone comes and says, "Arey, aapka dukaan achha hai," that shopkeeper, that boy will say, "Actually, ye puri mere pita aur mere dada ki kamai hai. My father has worked to put this shop together, my grandfather and my father. My job is only doing shutter up and shutter down." So like that, we disciples of the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, what we are doing is shutter up and shutter down. And whatever good commodity is seen in the shop, this is the hard work of our fathers and great grandfathers.
So Prabhuji, my question was that when we are going through the purpose of Srila Prabhupada, so there are certain purpose which are lengthy, and sometimes you tend to become a little impatient and you know you want to jump.
Yes.
And Srila Prabhupada has, you may correct me if I'm wrong, that he said that you know you read Bhagavatam from the beginning, right? Don't jump, you know, like that. So first question is how to, you know, have that patience. Second was when you talked about taking notes. So personally, I find writing a time consuming. So it's for me it is faster to, you know, just type it on my iPad.
Sure.
And but I have heard, you know, from many devotees and especially my wife, you know, she tells me, you know, you should write.
Yeah. So basically, the point is, two things are asked here. First is about the patience, and second is about the method of taking notes. Prabhupada said a couple of things in this regard. Srila Prabhupada at one point he said, one should systematically, scrutinizingly study. From first canto, like Bhagavad Gita, then Bhagavatam, then Chaitanya Charitam. In fact, it was Prabhupada who gave the terminology of, you know, this is like grad, post-grad, and so on and so forth. You know, undergrad, grad, post-grad. So that was one statement that Prabhupada made in this regard. But we can't just take that out of context. There are other statements that Prabhupada's made also. At another point, Prabhupada, when he was having Rasgulla, and someone said, Prabhupada, can we read the seventh canto? Because that describes Prahlad Maharaj. But I haven't read the first canto. Prabhupada said, my books, especially Srimad Bhagavatam, is like a Rasgulla. You can taste it from anywhere and it is sweet. So the caution here is, you can go to any canto, no problem. Because the third point in this regard that Prabhupada made is, many immature, I'm trying to remember the exact words. Prabhupada said, many inexperienced readers of the Srimad Bhagavatam frivolously jump to the 10th canto. But never will you see Prabhupada saying, inexperienced readers frivolously jumping to the 6th canto. That is not mentioned. Because most of them are interested in going to the 10th canto and that too in the Rasa Panchadhyaya. So what we should do is, we can jump wherever we want in the first 9 cantos. Jahan chalang lagaye koi baat nahi. You like third canto, you read that section and come back. You like fourth canto, read that section and come back. Fifth canto, come back. Sixth canto, come back. 10th canto also, if like for example Janmashtami is going on, Balaram Jayanti, you can read the first, the Balya Leela, as His Grace Radhesham Prabhu was explaining the other day, I think in the same place, right? Yeah. Prabhuji was explaining in that PowerPoint, quoting His Holiness Shivaram Maharaj Shuddha Bhakti Chintamani. That if you want, you can even go up to the childhood pastimes of Krishna, because Prabhupada has actually given Krishna book freely. So that's the 10th canto. Prabhupada gave the Rasgulla of the 10th canto far and wide. So somebody could say, yeah, 10th canto, but then there also very carefully we should go only to the first few chapters. Let's say up to Kaliya, which is about 15, 16, 17, tat tak theek hai. But after that, we should be a little cautious. Even up to Govardhan Leela, I would say it's okay. But just avoid chapter 21, which is Venu Geet. So the point is, systematically, yes. Well, 1-1-1, canto 1, chapter 1, text 1, is a long purport. So would we say if someone was not able to read through that purport, cannot read anything else in the Bhagavatam? No. You can go, read Prahlad Maharaj's teachings, and always you can come back. Read one paragraph of that purport. Take your notes, no problem. Take a break, go to 7th canto, read a couple of things, again come back. Till the time we are reading Prabhupada's books nicely, systematically, with sincerity, there is no problem. Only caution is Rasa Panchadhyaya, the five Geets, the Venu Geet, Gopi Geet, Brahmar Geet, Yugal Geet, Viraha Geet, must be avoided when we start reading, if it is our initial readings. That's one. Second, as far as the method of taking notes, the fundamental thing is, extracting the essence and tapping the points. Now, whether that you do it on one note, whether you do it on your laptop, whether you do it on the notebook, no problem. I am very old school, which means I am not so, although I have like 2 grad degrees in America, I am very handicapped as far as technology is concerned. Somehow when I see it on the laptop, I don't know, I somehow cannot connect. I want that, you know, notes here, ekdam likha hai, aise, alag alag color mein likha hai. You know, like Subhodini style. I can relate to that, especially when the pen hits the paper, that friction of writing, the fun of writing, I retain better when I write. So, wo I'm not able to do in my typing. If I have to, like, you know, make arrows, wo sab thoda, you know. You have to use a few tools on the laptop. But isme you just take a paper pen, banao ek cloud, banao ek table, banao, you know. It's easier. So for me, I prefer that. But is that the only way? No, definitely not. With technology, Prabhupada, yukta vairagya muchyate. Nirbande Krishna sambande yukta vairagya muchyate. Srila Radhanath Maharaj, I remember, was once speaking on, it was a prerna class at Radha Gopinath, where the topic was, life would have been much easier if apple and blackberry were just fruits. This was the topic. And Maharaj said, yes, this is true, but I cannot say much about it because I wrote Journey Home on a Apple laptop. You know. So the point is, yes, depending, moving with the technology, do we use it for preaching? Of course we do. Do we do live streaming? Do we do Facebook? Do we do YouTube? Yes, because it connects with jivas. Till when will we sit in the caves and just write on Talapatra? But as far as I am concerned, I prefer that. One last question, then we will wrap it up.
So, generally devotees, when you tell them to read sequentially and they come to second canto, the most difficult step, so you have some suggestions which will make, which can be, generally we have in Vidyapitam, where there's a hours together, we discuss chapters and it's little interesting. But for general people to read, it's little difficult. Do you have some suggestions how devotees can make reading of second canto also interesting?
I personally gained profusely by the Subodhini, the Bhagavad Subodhini by Gauranga Darshan Prabhu. Personally for me, it really helped in technical. Second canto, fir bhi I could scrape through. If not for Pavaneshwara Prabhu. The Vedic Prabhuji came and he was hammering Bhagavad cosmology and it was going over my head. What is happening? Kaunsa bhumandal kidhar? Then after that I surrendered. After 5th canto or 6th canto, I am Ajamil. 5th canto, I don't know, I will take the name and go. But my humble input here would be, study guides like Subodhini help for the 2nd canto. I spend a lot of time on the 2nd canto, systematically trying to understand and ask so many devotees. I sat with so many Brahmacharis and asking them, Prabhuji, what do you think? Isme kya hai? What is the essence? Ye pradhan, prakriti, mahatattva. How do I understand all this? Kahan se? Who is glancing? And who is carrying the glance? How does it work? Then gaining through so many senior Vaishnavas and writing down, recording it. I would go to ashram and then ask, Prabhuji, can I have your time? I want to, thoda time hai. Then senior Vaishnavas helped. So then their input. Classes from ISKCON Desiratory on second canto, if somebody has given, I would search, you know, if not for Vaishnava Seva Prabhu, ISKCON Desiratory. Jadi IDT na hoi to, tave ki hoi to. You know, so hearing classes from second canto, YouTube pe second canto pe kisi ne kuch diya hai kya on those verses, and then taking points from there, interacting with senior devotees, using Subodhani, and then my personal study, that is the best to which I could get through. Uske aage, I'm not sure, I'm not able to tap, but that was the best that I could.